Yeah, good morning, fellow Toastmasters and guests. I am Toastmaster Manas Naik, pleased to be your sergeant at arms for today's meeting. Now, I am opening Speaker Community Toastmaster Club's 32nd meeting officially. Today's theme, let me share some instructions which we need to follow in this online meeting environment. Request all of you to rename yourselves. All Toastmasters can prefix TM to your name and guests can prefix guest. I also request all the speakers and role holders to prefix their role to their name so that it's easy to identify them. I give you just 10 seconds for this activity. If any hurdles, then just let me know. I will be happy to help you. I would request you not to type in the chat box when a speaker speaking as it disturbs the speaker. You can use the private chat to provide feedback. You all are requested to keep your videos on if you are not moving around or sipping any drinks. And audio on mute in case you are not speaking. If you are a speaker, then please ensure you pin the timer and confirm that the same is visible at all times to you. You can connect with me for any technical glitches, as I am Sergeant at Arms as well as Tech Master for today's meeting. All speakers are requested to do a quick audio-video check before they start their speech. I will guide you on the setting if anyone requires. This meeting is being recorded. In case you have any reservation, please let us know. You can network after the meeting. Here we can display hi-fi or namaste when taking over or leaving from a role. So let me share the mission of our club. We provide a supportive and positive learning experience in which members are empowered to develop communication and leadership skills, resulting in greater self-confidence and personal growth. In today's meeting, we have a multi-channel, talented, dynamic, proactive, evergreen person with us, whose passion is coaching and guiding children, help them to achieve their education goals. And you know, nowadays she's going to be a cracker. Not that cracker. She's designing a sure set crash course for cracking IITG for 12th standard children. And I am really so excited to hold on this. So it's our privilege to have her as a presiding officer for that day. Now, without any delay, let me invite you, our presiding officer, with a round of applause. She is none other than Toastmaster Madhuvani. So, Madhuvani, over to you.
Thank you, Manas. I hope I'm audible. Thank you for the wonderful introduction. High five to you and all the Toastmasters. Good evening, Toastmasters and guests. Manas is a talented, enthusiastic, and down-to-earth Toastmaster I have ever known. He's just back from the area contest, Ebullience of M3, where he has successfully essayed the role of Zoom Master. A big round of applause to you, Manas. And put your hands together. Let us all applaud our winners of today's area contest. Distinguished Toastmaster Ankit, who stood second in the area level evaluation speech contest held in the morning today. We are proud of being part of the club where you are a senior XCOM member who enlighten us with all new ideas. Please keep us leading us in the right direction. Thank you, DTM Ankit. And yes, let us give a big round of applause to our very efficient Toastmaster Kalpana, who has made us proud by standing second in the HSE area level contest held in the morning today. So we are glad that you are a member of our club, Kalpana. Congratulations to you. I welcome you all for the 32nd meeting of the Speakers Community Toastmasters Club. We have just heard about the Toastmasters mission statement, which gives us the brief idea about the benefits of Toastmasters. Like Toastmasters helps us to build self-confidence in personal and professional lives. Toastmasters helps us to plan and run effective and efficient meetings. Toastmasters improves our communication. It makes it more clear and concise. So to put all these in one sentence, Toastmasters is a non-profit organization that specializes in strengthening public speaking and leadership skills. Without much ado, let us progress to the next segment. If we have guests in our meeting, please unmute yourself and tell us, what is your takeaway? What is that you're expecting from Toastmasters? Can the Zoom master help me if there are any guests in the meeting?
Yes, just 1 minute.
Yes.
Yeah, hi.
Hi.
Hi, this is Venkat.
Oh,
so I'm a guest for the today's meeting. So I just want to understand how Toastmaster functions, and I just want to develop my communication as well as the presentation skills. It is a part of my profession. Okay.
Welcome. Yep. You're at the right place.
Yep. Yes. Thank you.
Yes. Please go ahead, Venkat. You want to say something?
No, nothing. I just want to be a listener today so that further I can also join the Toastmaster Club. That's what. Yep.
Welcome, Venkat. You are at the right place. Please witness the entire meeting, and I'm sure by the end of it, we would want to know your feedback.
Sure.
Yeah. I bet. Thank you. Yes.
Thanks. Thanks a lot.
Welcome. So,
Sagarika is there.
Hi, Sagarika. Can we hear from you? Hello. Yes, you're on mute, Sagarika. Yeah, there is some background noise. If you can reduce the volume, maybe.
Yes.
Yeah, we can. You're audible, but there is some disturbance from behind. Nevertheless, you can speak. Yeah.
Sorry, I beg your pardon.
There is some background noise from your end.
Must be the AC.
Okay.
So I'll adjust that next time because I have to go to the settings and adjust it.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. Please go ahead. Tell us what is that you're expecting from Toastmasters, Sagarika.
Well, I have been in the area of communication since a very long time now.
Okay.
I've been a very poor communicator since my childhood, actually.
Okay.
Very silent and quiet child. And when I first opened my mouth to speak, I think I was the only spectator to myself.
Okay.
It was in the year 1985 in the ninth grade. I still remember when it was my attempt to express myself to my friends in a very small group, but I thoroughly failed despite the immense amount of courage I gathered within me. So eventually what happened is I went on this journey of communication, and I became a very good presenter in the sense that I began my career as a teacher. I was teaching biology and chemistry, and my students were used to be wrapped in attention, which gave me the confidence that I probably am a good presenter. But however, what happened is I realized that when I was in the class, I was very comfortable with my students, very comfortable with my fellow teachers. However, in my personal front or with very close people, I probably had a lot of conflict and lot of internal clashes, and it came to my way of communication ultimately.
Wonderful.
So
Sagarika, as I understand, what I feel is you're comfortable with the comfortable crowd. So you have to hone the skills and you want to improve your public speaking skills in the big, large crowd. That's what I understand from you.
Actually, I have a very long journey. I have spoken also 3 to 4 times in the World HRD Congress as a speaker. And I think I just need to fine tune my skills and be with this beautiful community and get your positive energy to take myself to the next step at the global level probably.
Great, great, great to hear that, Sagarika. Sorry to interrupt you. In fact, I would welcome you with open arms. This is the right platform. It's the right podium where you learn public speaking skills. It's a peer learning where you not only tend to improve yourself, but by looking at others speak and improve, you gain a lot of confidence. What I would request you is be there till the end, understand, and also be a part of the table topic segment of this meeting. You will learn more, so we will speak with you more in the end of the meeting also. Okay, thank you so much for speaking. Yes. Now, any other guests we have, if we can unmute and speak. You can mute, Sagarika. I request you to mute so that. Okay. Are we done with the? Yes. Before I start this 32nd meeting and give the stage to the very enthusiastic member as the Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Sachin, I would want to hear a few words from our own area director, Raj, who is very much here and he wants to also speak something. If he can. Speak in the start of the meeting. Yes, Raj, we want to know your point of view. Can we unmute Raj? Toastmaster Raj.
Hello, Madhubani. Hello, everyone. Good evening. Greetings for the day. Today, I am as official AD club visit for this Speakers Community Toastmasters Club. I would be as a silent observer for the meeting. And at the last moment, when meeting will get about to complete, I will share my feedback, my point of view for this club. Thank you. Over to you, Madhuban.
Okay. Thank you, Toastmaster Raj. So we all know Raj is observing us. So let us start the meeting. So I'm giving the stage, the virtual stage to very enthusiastic one, more enthusiastic Toastmaster, Toastmaster of the day, who has essayed the role of our awards share in today's area contest. So with a round of applause, let us all welcome our Toastmaster Sachin, Toastmaster of the day. He will take us through the journey of Toast to Adventure. Let him explain us more because he's fully prepared with that. So let us hear to him. Thank you so much. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you. Thank you so much, effervescent Presiding Officer Madhuvani, for the lovely introduction. A warm welcome to all the Toastmasters and dear guests present here to the 32nd meeting of Speakers Community Toastmasters Club. Allow me to tell you a brief of the structure of the meeting. The meeting is basically divided into 3 parts. The first part is prepared speech round, in which 2 different speakers or 3 different speakers, based on the availability, will present their prepared speeches based on the pathways they have taken and want to excel on. These speeches will be evaluated by the evaluator already assigned to them. Second is the table topic session, which is basically an impromptu session in which the table topic master will present us some topics and we have to speak on those topics for 1 or 2 minutes based on the time allotted. I request all the members and the guests to please volunteer this session. Third is the most important session, which is called the evaluation session, in which our general evaluator, Toastmaster Kalpana, with his plethora of experience, will evaluate all of our speeches as well as the general flow of the meeting with the help of the TAC team. Other speech evaluators and auxiliary role players, as I have told, the TAC team will lend a hand Kalpana to lend a hand to the general evaluator during the evaluation. I request general evaluator Kalpana to say a few lines to boost the confidence of all our speakers.
Thank you very much, Sachin, for that introduction. I hope to do complete justice and hope to learn also from the role that I've taken on today. Let me tell you briefly about my role. My role actually is to evaluate the whole meeting in general. I'll call for the reports from the speech evaluators, timer, grammarian, and our counter when I'm called upon. Next, I'll comment on the quality of the evaluation given by the evaluators of the prepared speeches and table topics. Thank you. Over to you, Sachin.
Thank you so much, General Evaluator Kalpana, and thanks for taking the role at the last minute also. So thank you so much for that.
Thank you.
Moving on, first let me introduce to one of the most important role player of the meeting, that is the Zoom Master. So today's meeting, Zoom Master is Toastmaster Manas. Toastmaster Manas, I request you to say hello and spotlight yourself and say hello to the team.
Hey everyone.
Thank you, Toastmaster Manas. Now allow me to introduce the auxiliary role players of today's meeting. That is grammarian, our counter, and timer. So today's grammarian is Toastmaster Shreya. I request Toastmaster Shreya to tell us a gist about her role in today's meeting. Over to you, Toastmaster Shreya.
Good morning. Good evening, Toastmaster of Day, fellow Toastmasters, and dear guests. I am the grammarian for the day. As grammarian, it is my responsibility to pay close attention to all the speakers, listening carefully to their language usage. I'll take note of any incorrect usage of grammar as well as any good usage of words, quotes, saying, and thoughts. I'll present my report as and when called by the general evaluator. As grammarian, it is my duty to introduce you to the word and phrase of the day. So word of the day is effervescent, which means vivacious and enthusiastic. It can be used as, she is one of those effervescent personalities that you often see hosting TV game shows. Phrase of the day is on the ball. If someone is on the ball, they are very alert and aware of what is happening. I couldn't sleep well last night, so I'm not on the ball today. That's all from my side. I hand it back to Sachin.
Thank you, Shreya. But you should be on the ball today to note all the good uses, right?
Sure.
Now I request the our counter of the day, Toastmaster Anisha, to tell us about her role in today's meeting. Toastmaster Anisha, over to you. The Zoom stage is all yours. You are on mute.
Good evening, Toastmaster of the Day, fellow Toastmasters, and guests. I'm our counter of the day. As an our counter, I will note words and sounds that are used as crash and fillers by the speaker. During the meeting, I will listen to the crash words such as and, well, but, so, and you know. I will also listen for filler sounds such as or. I will note when a speaker repeats a phrase such as I, or this means, and long and short pauses too. I will give my report when called by the journal evaluator. Thank you, and over to you, Toastmaster of the Day.
Thank you so much, Anisha. Now I would request the timer for the day, that is Toastmaster Sharin, to tell us something about her role. Toastmaster Sharin, over to you.
Good evening, Toastmaster of the Day, fellow Toastmasters, and my dear guests. I am the timer for the day. As a timer, it is my duty to time the prepared speeches, the table topics, and the evaluations. So, for the prepared speeches, the time allotted varies as per the project. The table topics is for 1 to 2 minutes. And the evaluation is for 2 to 3 minutes. I will be displaying the green screen at the minimum qualifying time, yellow screen at the midpoint of the qualifying time, and the red screen at the maximum qualifying time. I will just show my screen so that, I don't have access to the screens, to screen sharing, but...
Anas, can you please give other rights?
Right now, Sarin?
Yes, I can now. So is my screen visible?
Yes, it is.
Yes. So this is the green screen, the yellow screen, and the red screen, which I will be showing at the minimum qualifying time, the maximum, and the middle point. There is a grace period of 30 minutes. The prepared speech will get 30 minutes before the minimum qualifying time and after the maximum qualifying time. And for the table topics, there is 30 seconds only after the qualifying time. I will present my table, I will present my report when called upon by the general evaluator. Hoping to see all the effervescent speakers. Thank you, and over to you, Toastmaster of the Day.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Sharon. First of all, I'll request everyone to please be on mute because there are so much background noise is coming. Yeah, thank you so much. So moving on, let me introduce the theme of the meeting. Theme of the today's meeting is Toast to Adventure. I'll raise my glass at the end, but at start, let me ask you all that what is the first thing that comes to your mind when you think of the word adventure? What do you think? For me, it's the trip, right? Anything you can write in the chat box. Come on, everyone. Anything, just one word. Like some destinations you want to go or some destinations you have been, like, right? So these are the adventurous thing you have in your mind, going beyond your limits, correct, Anget. Doing something which you have asked not to do. Great, Sharon. Adrenaline rush, correct, trick. Yeah, great, great. Thank you. Thank you so much for the responses. So, but for me, my life itself has been an adventure. Or should I say the adventure has been a part and parcel of my life. From my childhood days, I am very fond of nature. My father in 90s had bought a land at a place where there were no houses nearby or no shops were nearby. Right. So my house was fully surrounded by the jungle. And at night, the wild animals like fox, wolves, and these jackals used to roam around the house and make such a terrifying sounds, you know. So, but earlier we used to do the washrooms were kept away from the main houses, like because of the traditions, right? So it was the same with me. And when at night I have to use it, then I run so fast that after some time I realized that I might have done a better role than Tom Hanks in the movie Forrest Gump. Like, if you know, run, Forrest, run. Run, Sachin, run. It was like that. So at the early stage, even I was not aware of the word adventure, it has become a very, integral part of my life. You know, snakes. Snakes were so common that they were found inside the almirahs. That was the thing. I remember once I was playing cricket with my friends and a huge snake came from nowhere and just started crossing the pitch. And we all were like, okay, we'll wait, you cross, then we'll play. So that was the thing at that time. So it was a total dense forest, so anything can come from anywhere. So, okay. Now, I want to tell you another story. So at that time, when I was a child, I used to have nearly 80 to 20 neem trees at my home. And, in the month of August and September, in Hindi, we call it the month of Savan. We used to put the ropes on the neem trees and make the swing to have some fun, right? So at that time, I with my friends put the ropes over the trees and we also climb over the trees to make it perfect and all. So this full activity is itself full of adventure. So I'll tell you a funny thing about that. we used to take a big log, like suppose this is a log, the flat log, and we'll use to tie the rope from here and from here like this. And three people used to sit in between the log here, between the ropes. One people not sit, but stand here at the brim of the log, and the other stand here at the brim of the log holding the rope. So what these two people were responsible to apply the pressure to make the swing go like this. So when it is come at this level, then he puts the pressure with his legs, it goes like this, and then it comes like, so no other person is responsible to make a swing. So it's like that. So it happens that we are just, it goes like this, up to 180 degrees goes like this. But in several stances I have seen, it goes above 180 degrees. And what happened then, these two people who were standing at the brim, they were found on the floors rolling in the dirt. So these are some of the funniest moments and adventures which I have done at the early stage of my life. So I have many other stories to tell you guys, but in the interest of time, let me move forward to the first phase of the meeting. So the first phase of the meeting is prepared speech round. So our first speaker is Toastmaster Aarti. Toastmaster Aarti, you there? Yeah, she's there. Toastmaster Aarti, and to evaluate her speech, we have distinguished Toastmaster Ankit. Requesting distinguished Toastmaster Ankit to tell us a brief of the objective of Toastmaster Aarti's speech. Over to you, distinguished Toastmaster Ankit. I request Zoom Master to please spotlight DTM Ankit. Thank you.
Thank you, Sachin, for such an effervescent topic. Toastmaster Aarti is attempting the project mentoring. The purpose of the project is for the member to clearly define how Toastmasters envisions mentoring. Timer, please note, the time is 5 to 7 minutes. I wish the speaker Aarti all the best. Thank you and over to you.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster, distinguished Toastmaster Ankit. Toastmaster Aarti, I request Zoom Master to please spotlight Toastmaster Aarti, and I request Timer to please share the screen for the time card. Toastmaster Aarti, the card's visible to you?
Yes.
Okay. You are audible and visible. Toastmaster Aarti, mentoring. Mentoring, Toastmaster Aarti.
The delicate balance of mentoring. Mentoring someone is not creating them in your own image, but giving them the opportunity to create themselves. So said Stephen Spielberg. Good evening, Toastmaster of the day, fellow Toastmasters and guests. Mentoring is a softer and more relationship-focused form of guidance as opposed to a structured training approach coaching often takes. With mentoring, mentee is responsible for driving the sessions and steering the relationship. Show me a successful individual and I will show you someone who had real positive influence in his or her life. I don't care what you do for a living. If you do it well, I am sure there was someone cheering you on or showing the way. That's the role of a mentor. We have seen many coaching classes for different skills. Have you ever seen any mentoring classes? Just like charity begins at home, my grandparents had a special bond with me. They told me many motivational stories that helped me see the world from a different angle. My parents set an example by their way of living life. My father, a principal, had taught me honesty. One day, an elderly person and his son arrived to our home on Sunday. He tried to bribe my father. I remember the exact words of my father today also. As you are elder to me, and I don't want to insult you, Don't never ever try to bribe me. If your son deserves the job, he will definitely get it in my school. My mother, a kind-hearted and generous lady.
Sharon, I can stop the time.
Let me call her. I think there's some technical glitch.
I have stopped the stream.
Start from another point.
You can start from where you left.
Students, start from another device.
This is fine, Aarti. You can continue.
Hello.
Yeah, Aarti, you can continue from where you left.
Hello.
Yeah, Aarti, you are audible. You can continue from where you left.
Okay, I am audible.
Yeah.
Should I start again?
No, from you, where you left, you just start from there.
Voice is very low. I don't know why.
Start from where you left, na?
I'll start from. The delicate balance of mentoring someone is not creating them in your own image, but giving them the opportunity to create them. So said Steven Spielberg. Good evening, Toastmaster of the day, fellow Toastmasters and guests. Mentoring is a softer and more relationship-focused form of guidance as opposed to structured training approach. Coaching often is. With mentoring, mentee is responsible for driving the sessions and steering the relationships. Show me a successful individual and I will show you someone who had real positive influence in his or her life. I don't care what you do for a living. If you do it well, I'm sure. There was someone hearing you or showing you. That's the role of mentoring. We have seen many coaching classes for different schools. Have you ever seen any mentoring classes? Just like Jeremy from my grandparents had a special bonding. They told me many motivational stories that helped me see the world from a different angle. My parents set an example by their way of living life. My father, a principal, taught me honesty. One day, an elderly person and his son arrived at my home. At our home of friend, he tried to bribe my mom. I still remember the exact words my father told me. As you are elder to me, I don't want to insult you. You can leave. You can leave. But if your son deserves the job, he will definitely get it in my school. my mother. A kind heart, generous. We were a joint family. Many a time, her feelings were hard. But she was always at the attitude of forgiving and forgetting. She will start the relationship with you know, and never complain. I am mentoring myself to follow in her footsteps. A good friend is more worthy than a mentor. A friend, coach, and wellness, Kalpana, whom I call Kalpana, and now Toastmaster. She asked me if I would like to join Toastmasters. I knew that some hidden in the interest of for my wellness. I found a good listener, flexible, knowledgeable, non-judgmental, honest, and caring friend as my mother, Toastmaster Kalpana. She helped me prepare speeches and is always there for myself. My official mentor was Madhuvani. She always guided me. Cream of the crop, always smiling, a mentor. Toastmaster Anki taught me what selfless help means. A solid rock of support, approachable, kind, passionate, and always responded with a positive note. He always encouraged me behind the scenes, not to, I was not tech savvy or computer savvy. I was lost every time when I was asked to submit the evaluation form. But Toastmaster Sai Kumar, who has evaluated most of my speeches, has always been cooperative. Sai mentored me indirectly by teaching me patience and delivering a task 100%, even with limited resources. My dear colleagues and friends, Toastmasters, who joined me in my Toastmasters journey, have also mentored me. How can I forget Toastmasters? Today, I have learned to do the role of a timer, screen sharing on Zoom with complete professionalism. Thank you, sir. Toastmaster Manas, I can say, the gem of a person, has been indirectly inspiring me to keep smiling in any situation. Thank you, Toastmaster. Toastmaster Seren, her calm and composed presenting style is something I am trying to emulate as a mentor. Toastmaster Seren, I appreciate your liveliness during the meeting. Toastmaster Amit, your active participation in presenting. Toastmaster Dheeraj, a humble and supportive person always. Toastmaster Anissa, Toastmaster Nikita, Toastmaster Francis. Thank you all for mentoring, for support and encouraging me. You all mentored me at some point or the other. Mentoring can take various forms. After I joined Toastmasters, I have seen difference in my daughter's attitude. To my surprise, my daughter has made me her mentor. She too joined a public speaking classes and asked me to assist her with her speech. As Toastmaster, I have been given the opportunity to create myself positively. Thank you, mentors, for shaping me from Aarti to Toastmaster. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Aarti. It was a wonderful speech. May I have a round of applause for Toastmaster Aarti. Now, moving on to our second speaker and the last one for today is Toastmaster Sai Kumar. And to evaluate his speech, we have Toastmaster Madhuvani. I request Toastmaster Madhuvani to provide us the objective of Toastmaster Sai Kumar's speech. Over to you, Toastmaster Madhuvani.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Sachin. Speaker Toastmaster Sai Kumar is attempting his level 3 speech 1, delivering social speeches. The purpose of this speech is for the member to practice delivering social speeches in front of our club members. And the timing for this speech is 3 to 4 minutes. Timer, please note. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day, and all the best, Toastmaster Sai.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Madhuani. Toastmaster Sai Kumar, I request Zoom Master to please spotlight Toastmaster Sai Kumar. Thank you so much, Toastmaster Manas. Toastmaster Sai Kumar, are the cards visible to you?
Yes.
You are perfectly audible and visible also. Toastmaster Sai Kumar, rise together. Rise together, Toastmaster Sai Kumar.
A toast you can have in the morning and a toast you can cheer for someone. Good evening, Toastmaster of the day, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. Today, I am feeling effervescent, excited and energetic to raise a toast for me, you and all the lovely audience of Speakers Community Toastmasters Club. This toast is very special for me because it has all the ingredients of sweet wine mixed with flavor of mint and jaggery. Here, the ingredients I mean the hard work and dedication of each and every member, the interest to learn and experiment new things, the zeal of enthusiasm floating around, the aroma of happy and pleasant environment seen each and every time. 7 months ago, a new dream, a new plan was planted to improve our communication and leadership skill. Today, the seeds of inspiration, the plant which was planted 7 months ago, has grown into full blossom. I want to raise a toast and say big, big congratulations to all the members of Speakers Community Toastmasters Club. 7 stepping stone towards success. 7 wonderful stars, along with few enthu members, 7 months ago, went on to venture a new club, Speakers Toastmasters Community Club. Within 1 month, it spread the wings of success with flying colors and set new dimension. In the very first month, we received an overwhelming responses in club, international speech and table topic contest. The quality of speeches shook the audience and made them think, is it a 1 month old club? Adding cherry on the top, our club member, Toastmaster Kalpana, represented at division level in table topic contest, Toastmaster Parvati at area level in international speech contest. Our guiding star, the angel, the servant leader, DTM Ankit Das Gupta, winning the best division director award for the year. Toastmaster Madhuvani, the president leading from the front with Pathway Award. The vibrant and the energetic star, Toastmaster Manas, winning the best outstanding Toastmaster Award. VP membership, Toastmaster Sherin, with the Pre Smedley Toastmaster Award. And the Superman, the super cool savior, Toastmaster Sachin, the VP Education, awarded with Best Toastmaster Award. And our entire club winning transparency
in administration award, Toastmasters administration award. This is really remarkable. I would say this is just the beginning. And today we have added one more feather to the cap. Our own members, DTM Ankit and Toastmaster Kalpana, represented at M3 area level in humorous speech and evaluation contest and securing the second position. I want to tag each and every member for this success. And I would request everyone to rise together, unmute yourself and cheer with me. Hip hip.
Hooray.
Hip hip.
Hooray.
Hip hip.
Hooray.
Thank you.
Hooray.
Over to Toastmaster.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Sai Kumar. That was a wonderful speech. May I have a round of applause for Toastmaster Sai Kumar? And now I'll request timer to present the timing report. Toastmaster Sharin.
Yes, sir. So Aarti's timing was 6 minutes 37 seconds and Sai's timing was close one, 4 minutes 29 seconds.
So both are qualified?
Yes, both are qualified.
Thank you so much, Sharin. But since we have only two speakers, so we're not having a poll today. Okay. Now moving on to the second part, that is the table topic round, which will be handled by Toastmaster Aarti. I request Zoom Master to please spotlight Toastmaster Aarti. Toastmaster Aarti, over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the Day. Am I audible?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the Day, fellow Toastmasters and guests. Very good evening. I am Aarti, Table Topic Master for today. This is an impromptu session of our Toastmasters meeting. It is an interesting session which will give a chance to Toastmasters and guests to share their listening, sharpen their listening, thinking, organizing, and speech delivering skill. For table topics, the allotted time is 1 to 2 minutes. Green card will be displayed at 1 minute, yellow card at 1.5 minutes, and red card at 2 minutes. 30 seconds of grace period is given after red card. Speaker has to speak for a minute. Speaker has to speak for a minute to qualify for the voting. All the speakers are requested to use the word of the day and phrase of the day. I encourage members and guests to volunteer for the session. Now, let me begin with the session. Who would like to participate first? Yes, any volunteer? Toastmaster Pranli. Yes, I was thinking about you only. Okay, unmute yourself.
Hello.
Yes.
Yes, Aarti. Am I audible? You see?
Yes. Can you see the timer card?
Yes.
Toastmaster Pranli, participating is a fun or fear? Toastmaster Pranli.
Thank you, Aarti. Yes. The topic is participating for fun over fear.
No, participating, right? A fun or fear?
A fun for fear. Sorry, can you repeat the topic?
Frankly, participating is fun or fear?
Okay, participating fun or fear. It is an option. Okay, thank you, Arti.
Yes.
To start with, I have already noted, it is fun or fear. It is the option. It is the option which we would like to execute. Anytime when you participate for some program or any activity, you have both the feelings in your mind. You have fear, and if you overcome the fear, you will enjoy the fun of it. As already all are the members of Toastmasters Club, we all know what is the fun in overcoming that fear of stage daring and appearing before many unknown speakers and guests, where we present ourselves and overcome the fear and get the fun of achieving what we deserve. Not living besides the Toastmasters topic, I can cite one more example in real life. When we drive the two-wheeler or four-wheeler for the first time, no doubt, everybody is afraid. Everybody has the fear of traffic and the fear of unknown. What will come in your way, you never know. But when you overcome that fear, you are the winner. You enjoy that ride and every unknown road that leads to the destination will add to the fun of driving. And that fun is always enjoyable in any journey of life. So I'll conclude, for any participation, we start with fear but end up with fun. Thank you.
That was wonderful. Now, I would like another participant, volunteer. Yes, Toastmaster Manas. Can you see the timer card?
Yes.
You are audible. Toastmaster Manas, your first experience as a participant. Your first experience as a participant, Toastmaster Manas.
Manas, you should not tell like this. This gives a bad impact on audience. This is beyond my thinking that I could got this type of, we can say that evaluations from our evaluator. So this is my first experience when I gave a speech during my college days on that speech contest. So after that, this gave me a lot of encourage this evaluation. This gives effervescent, enthusiastic, it gives me a kick to give a speech in that, unknown persons, in front of unknown persons. And this is a real sweet memory and which I kept with me as of now also, and always it is that first speech always a memorable for everyone. So it's a good one. Thank you, Arti.
That was wonderful. Now, any guest would like to participate? Guest Sagrika, yes. You are visible, and can you see the timer card?
Yeah.
Guest Sagrika, Your role model, guess Sagrika.
My role model. Okay. As a woman, I have always tried to search for people whom I could emulate because I feel women have several challenges in their life. And it's not easy to do one's best, to bring out the best in oneself, as well as adjust to the immediate society around you. And they might be your close ones, or little one, or the ones who are a little farther from you. So I have always emulated one person in my life, that was my aunt. She was a person from whom I have learned a lot of things, despite the fact that she had lot of internal qualities. She was a brilliant student, a prolific reader, orator, and writer. And above all, she had a very effervescent self to herself, in the sense that she used to be the jaan of the crowd. She used to attract people towards herself by her wit, by the way she spoke and the way she carried herself. Although she was a very simple person in her heart, but when she used to speak, every word were like gems. They were like treasures. They were things that people would not forget for a long time. And I used to observe her since a very small age, and I was very curious to know what made her so driven towards her qualities. Like she had done a lot of studies under psychology and produced a lot of PhDs under her, who are now the heads of departments of several organizations and institutions. And she was my role model. Unfortunately, I lost her, but I stay with her qualities and I have imbibed her qualities today in me to the extent possible. And what was the best part about is that she believed in service to mankind, and I also live by that mission of providing service to mankind. So as a communication coach, my idea is to serve mankind in a spiritual way. I include spirituality also into my communication coaching. So because I feel everybody here in mankind is thirsty of human connection, and communication is just not tactical, or is not connected to the psychology of the mind, but also there is a spiritual element to it, which we tend to forget in today's world, because communication should be a tool for human connection. That is what I personally believe, and that is my mission today. So her qualities have helped me to become a better human being and a better professional, and also a person who can render my services to the world in a much greater way with more meaning. So thank you very much.
Thank you. That was wonderful. Now, any other guest? Guest Venki, would you like to?
Yeah, I can, but I'm not sure that whether I can respond to a topic. Yes, I can just give a try for that.
No, that's not a problem. You can try, and I'm sure you will be able to speak. Venki, beauty is skin deep.
I'm sorry?
Beauty is skin deep.
Beauty is, I can understand the next word.
Indeed. Beauty is skin deep.
Skin deep. Skin deep.
Yes.
I couldn't understand that word. Skin deep in the sense. Let me do that one in the next meeting. Is that fine? I'm sorry.
Okay, no problem. Sure.
Thanks.
Any other participant?
I'll go for it, Aarti.
Okay. Toastmaster Ankit, can you see the timer card?
Yes.
Okay. Toastmaster Ankit, magic is believing in yourself. Magic is believing in yourself, Toastmaster Ankit.
Table topic master, Toastmasters and guests. Magic is believing in yourself. I'm not sure who said this, but I can totally relate to this quote. Over the course of my journey, since my childhood days to where I am now, I've realized that you need to have confidence in your own abilities. And if you have confidence in your own abilities, then even if the destination is not reached, but the journey can be enjoyed. But that doesn't mean if you fail at one point of time that you won't succeed at the other. It's the belief in yourself that will take you to the right track. Let me give you an example. Today, both Toastmaster Kalpana and I participated in the area contest level. Both of us worked pretty hard, and I'm sure Kalpana did too, because we wanted to give our best. It's not about the trophy, but it's about ensuring that at the end of the day, you are able to give 100%. And that is what keeps us happy. And that's what I believe we did. I can talk for herself. I can talk for Toastmaster Kalpana too, because we have spoken about this. And what I've realized is contests help you become better and know different aspects of yourself. Before the contest, I was not knowing a lot of things about evaluations, but during this course of a week, I got to know a lot of things, spoke to a lot of people. And I did that because I was there in a contest and I believed that I could do it. Hence, it becomes very important that you believe in yourself, that you can achieve a goal. And if you believe in yourself, no matter whenever it comes, you will be able to achieve your goal some other day. So keep trying, keep believing, and keep trusting yourself. Thank you, and over to you, Aarti.
Thank you. That was wonderful. Now, I would like to invite Timer for her timer report. Zoom Master, please, can you spotlight sharing?
Thank you, Table Topic Master Aarti. Our first speaker, Pranjali, took 2 minutes, 1 second. Manas took 1 minute, 24 seconds. Sagarika took, guest Sagarika took 3 minutes, 27 seconds. And Toastmaster Ankit took 2 minutes. So everyone is qualified except our guest, Sagarika.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sarin. Now I would like to request our Zoom master. Can we launch the poll?
Manas, I think I've launched the wrong poll.
Please tell me once again.
It's done, Arthur.
Okay, thank you, Manas. Now, I would like to hand over this control back to the Toastmaster of the day. Over to you.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Aarti. It was a wonderful session. Now allow me to proceed further on the terms of the theme of the meeting. And in this session, I will ask you guys to tell us one adventurous thing that you feel about your hometown or something that fascinates you, you know. So first I will start with myself, and by that time you can think of something. Okay. So I really want everyone to volunteer this session because it's so easy. So I'm from a place called Allahabad, now Prayagraj, which is known for the world popular Kumbh Mela. So where in 2013, more than 120 million visitors have visited that from around all over the world, you know, around the Sangam place, which has been where three different holy rivers, Ganga, Yamuna, and Saraswati, invisible Saraswati meet. So it's known as a holy place, basically. Also, do you know one of the fact about Allahabad? It is known as the Prime Minister State of India. Prime Minister City of India, sorry. You know why? Because 7 out of 15 prime ministers is from this city. Yeah, that's correct. 7 out of 15, nearly 50%. So now I would like someone to please volunteer and tell us something, some adventurous thing about your hometown. Anyone?
Hi, Toastmaster Sachin.
Yes, I.
So yeah, coming to my city, so I belong to Kerala, and what I want to say is a very beautiful place, like a beaches and all, which I explore in Hunnikon. And one thing I enjoy the most is the South Indian food, the idlis spread with entire river of sambar around, and the chutneys, which is very, very beautiful. And I enjoy the South Indian food whenever I visit my home. Thank you
so much, Sai. Thank you. I do like South Indian food so much. I nearly spent my 4 or 5 years in the South studying for BTech. So I like it so much. Yeah, anyone else? Sharin?
Yes, Sachin. I will continue this Kerala story. And I'm sure Sai and Kalpana would understand this. So we have people who pluck coconut from the coconut trees. So they will only wear a lungi and they will have this cloth tied around their head. And with only that cloth, they will remove that cloth. And with only that cloth, they will climb this huge tree with only that cloth. That is that one thing that amuses me. And they have this knife thingy that they have to cut the coconut. And they will do everything with just having their balance with that cloth and only that. So that is one thing that amuses me at my place.
Thank you so much, Sharin. Where are you from, Sharin?
Kerala.
Kerala. Okay, great. Thanks. Yeah, Kalpana, go ahead. Please go ahead. I request Manas to please spotlight people who are speaking.
Yes, you know, Sachin, actually, when you just spoke about the place, your childhood that you had spent, it reminded me not of my childhood. I wanted to speak about childhood, but enough of Kerala. I'm going to talk about Assam. The snakes that you mentioned were far more rampant in Assam. So there have been times when I have actually been walking on the road and literally held my foot like this to allow a cobra to pass from beneath my foot and trying not to freak out. I've also had occasions where I had to help my daughter behind me because I have felt a rustle, you know, in the leaves and realized that there is a snake and it also wants to cross the path. So I waiting for it to pass. Other adventures probably that I faced in Assam were not the jackals and the wolf, but of course the biggest mammal, the earth mammal, elephants. There have been times when we used to go to centralized transit accommodation or a guest house where we generally had our parties at night. On one such occasion, a herd of elephants was right outside the bungalow, and the man who had just driven in at the party, he couldn't get out from his driver's seat, got out from the passenger seat, the car was in the gear and the baby elephant played with the car as if it was a ball and put it down across in the valley. So I think our adventures, and I think Aarti, who is right now again, of course, in Big Boy, can share some of the elephants that visits her every night at her bungalow. She has got the recordings of it. So I think it is an adventurous life because every day you don't know what animal you're going to encounter. Over to you, Sachin.
Thank you so much, Kalpana. That's wonderful. Yeah, Pranjali, please go ahead.
Adding to Kalpana, we are also staying in the heart of Mumbai, but the colony we have is a government colony and it is spread over 4 to 5 acres. And we have lots of greenery over here that is admirable. But the snake incidents that Kalpana shared, I have the same incidents with me. I was driving on a scooter and my two younger kids were sitting at the back of me. And we had at the center of the road, there was a cobra sitting. And I just have to skip with my scooter, not disturbing the cobra and going away without screaming and having any disturbance. So that was one adventure. Earlier I thought of sharing my native place, what you told. I belong to Aurangabad, which is a city in Maharashtra. Near that city, there is a Daultabad fort, which you cannot say adventure, but it is a historical place. Even we have Ajanta and Ellora, which are historical monuments and very important from World Trade Heritage and also. And we have one more temple where there is a only statue of Hanumana, which is sleeping. And the adventure I wanted to share is many people believe that if you go to that temple about 7 times or 14 times walking barefooted, all your wishes get granted. So many of the dwellers from Aurangabad, they head towards this temple every Saturday. It is about 30-40 kilometers away from the city, and they go barefoot walking, and it really have another angle of it, that people go in the groups and they share the adventure of trekking like scene, but that has another angle to it of getting their wishes fulfilled. So that is what I wanted to share from my native place. Over to you, Sachin.
Thank you so much, Pranjali. Thank you. Thank you, everyone, for volunteering this. Thank you.
So I want to share.
Yeah, sure.
Like, there is this one thing about Delhi Heights. If you tell them to not do something, they are going to do that very thing. So if I don't want to go to a haunted place, my friends would be really willing to take me over there forcefully, even if they have to. Yes.
Yeah, that's it. Thanks. So with that, now I would like to raise the glass. I don't have glass, I will raise the cup. For all the adventurous moment we had, or we are going to have in the future. These adventurous moments helps in adding the sweetest and the magnificent memories in life that we can cherish forever. Right? Now with that, I would like to proceed with the third part of our meeting, that is the general evaluation meeting. And our today's general evaluator is Toastmaster Kalpana. Toastmaster Kalpana, I would like, Zoom Master, please spot it, Toastmaster Kalpana. Thank you. The Zoom stage is all yours.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Sachin. I would first like to call upon, the evaluators. Time report. What was the time taken by evaluators? I think it has been done, right?
No, evaluation is pending, right?
Yeah. I think, yes, what? If I am right, Ankit and Madhuvani, both of them need to evaluate the speeches. So can I call upon Ankit, Toastmaster Ankit, to give an evaluation of the speech of Toastmaster Aarti? Over to you, Ankit.
Everyone, please mute yourself.
Aarti has logged it from two devices. Okay. I can see the timer's card. Thank you. Great. A mentor is not someone who walks ahead of you and shows you how it is to be done, but walks beside you and does it with you. General Evaluator, Toastmasters, and my speaker, Aarti. What a wonderful speech on mentoring. Thank you for making us realize the importance of a mentor and mentee relationship. What I loved about the speech was first, the personal examples. Stories and personal examples sell, and they make you connect with the audience at a higher level. And you had personal examples throughout your speech, be it with your grandfather, be it with your mother, be it with your friends. And I could totally relate to your speech because you had those characters which are there in every one of our lives. So thank you for giving personal examples to Toastmaster Aarti. The second thing that I loved about your speech and I'm really grateful for is your body language. Thank you for standing and giving a speech. At this time of a virtual scenario where everyone sits down and gives a speech, it creates a lot of difference, not only in the audience's mind, but even in your own personality when you stand and give a speech, because you have the whole stage to walk around and give a speech. I'm sure those who have done this will agree with me. So thank you for doing that and taking the extra effort of standing and giving a speech. And you also had good hand gestures to amplify your speech. Hand gestures amplify speech and makes your point clear to the audience. Thank you for doing that. The third part and the best part that I loved about your speech was your gratitude that you gave to each and every member of our club who made a difference in your life. Sometimes we take a lot of things, but we forget to reciprocate or give back. But you didn't do that. You came in and you showed the gratitude. Even if anyone had touched your life, even for a small second, you showed that gratitude. And that's very important in a person's life or a person's personality in terms of showing the gratitude of what people have done to them. Thank you for doing that. Now, I have 3 points of recommendation for you, Toastmaster Aarti. First one is your voice and hand gestures. Although you were standing and giving a speech, I would have loved it if you had used your hands for showing your characters or showing the different people that you were talking about. Your hands were just moving randomly here and there. I would have loved it if you have used your hands for emulating your characters. That would have added to your speech. The second aspect that I felt you could have done better was your topic. Mentoring, it's a very easy topic. I would have loved it if you had made your topic a bit interesting. That would have given me an inclination of what you might be telling at the end in your speech. The third part and the most important part that I felt I could have done better was the conclusion. Conclusion gives a lasting impression in an audience mind, and what is said at the last lasts forever. So I would have loved it if you have given a good conclusion at the end wherein you could have connected back to the audience or summarized your speech. Overall, a beautiful speech which had personal examples, which had body language, which had the feeling of gratitude. If you would have worked on your hand gestures, your topic, and your conclusion, it would have been an excellent speech. Thank you, Toastmaster Aarti, for showing your gratitude towards all of us. And we are grateful to have you in our club. Thank you, and over to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you, DTM Ankit, for that evaluation. I now request our presiding officer, Madhuvania, President, to give an evaluation for Toastmaster Sai Kumar's speech. Over to you, Madhuvani.
Thank you, General Evaluator Kalpana, and my target speaker, Toastmaster Sai Kumar. Before I would start evaluation, I would want to quote the famous quote of Ritwik: a tiny sapling can feed the world, and a small hope can lead the lives. After listening to your speech, my emotions and feelings, I started thinking how much they are associated with Speakers Community Toastmasters Club. I'm very proud to say that I'm the charter member of Speakers Community Toastmasters Club. On listening to your speech,
I feel the saplings were planted at the right place 7 months back, and they have turned into a fruitful land today. The words of appreciation that came out of your mouth today, they appeared like pearls of facts to me. You made me think, what if saplings would talk? You made me think how saplings would talk. They would talk about the zeal of all the members. They would talk about the interest of our members in taking up roles. And they would also talk about the hard work to put up the show at the right time. Toastmaster Sai Kumar, I would say that this fruitful land of our speakers community Toastmasters Club has pleasant, sweet aroma of success and achievements. If I would want to comment on your speech, you had excellent word variety. The choice of words was excellent and absolute clarity in what you wanted to say. When you said that, raise the toast for Speakers Community Toastmasters Club along with the glass, it showed how comfortable you were. And when you asked everyone to unmute themselves, we were all very enthusiastic to say hip hip hooray. So that showed your connect with the audience. But Toastmaster Sai Kumar, surrounding all saplings, there are always weeds which we don't want them to grow, right? I would say there is a recommendation. The weed in the saplings was, where is the takeaway for the speech? Why should we join Speakers Community Toastmasters Club? If you could have added some takeaway to the speech. I know it is the toast and a social speech, but still I felt the need for conclusion. Nevertheless, great word variety, great clarity, and audience awareness. But a small line of conclusion would have really made the garden very colorful. So all the best to your future speeches, and over to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you, Presiding Officer Madhuvani. I would now like to ask the timer reports have been given for both the segments. Am I correct, Shirin?
Yes, all yes, right. General Evaluator.
I request the R counter. I think R counter was, I think blank. Just give me a second. I have written it down.
Kalpana, I'll give the report for the evaluations.
For the evaluations? Excuse me? For the timer report?
Yeah, for the evaluations.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you for that, Shirin. Yes, Sharon, over to you.
So our first evaluator, Ankit, had 3 minutes, 29 seconds. And our second evaluator, Madhuvani, had 3 minutes, 8 seconds. So both are correct.
Thank you, Timer Sharon, for that report. I now move on to Anisha to give her our report. Over to you, Anisha.
Am I able to? You can hear me? Okay. So the report is like this. Toastmaster Aarti has taken 4 hours, 2 1 hour, and a short pause. Toastmaster Sai Kumar, 1 hour. Toastmaster Priyanjali, 2 hour, 1 hour, and a short pause. Toastmaster Manas, 4 hours and 2 repeated words. Guest Sagarika, 2 hours, 1 and a short pause. Toastmaster Ankit, 1 hour. Toastmaster Sachin, 4 hours, 3 and a short pause. Toastmaster Madhubani, 1 hour and a repeated word. That's all. Back to you, General Evaluator.
you are on mute, Kalpana.
Thank you for that report, Anisha. Now, may I call upon grammarian Shreya for her report on grammar?
Yes.
Thank you, grammarian Shreya.
So, word of the day has been used by Ankit, Sachin, Sharon, Sai Kumar, and Sagarika. Phrase of the day has been used by Sachin. Some good words that have been observed during the meeting. Sachin used magnificent and plethora. Aarti used following the footsteps, tech savvy, emulate. Sai Kumar used raise a toast, zeal, aroma of happy and pleasant environment. Cherry on the top, vibrant. Savior, remarkable, adding feather to the cap. Madhubani used a tiny sapling can feed the world and a small hope can lead the lives. Ankit used reciprocate and inclination. And some Sagarika used bring out the best, emulate, prolific, imbibe, live by that, tactical and render. And some corrections are, it's not share one another story, it's sharing another story. We don't use one with another in that sense. And another correction could be, we use first form of verb with could. So could, it's not could got, it's could get. That's all for the report. I'm sorry for my voice, a little sick. Thank you.
Thank you, grammarian Shreya, for that detailed report. Now, I liked the fact that the meeting actually began on time despite all the members were being so pressurized and extremely busy with the contests that are going on. The Sir, as usual, began with his good morning, and I always feel that I'm leaving two Sundays whenever I hear his good mornings. He then handed over, introducing Madhubani with an aplomb, and Madhubani opened really well. She introduced Ankit, who really is a pillar, and I can see the change of him as we all depend a lot and lot more on him. Not a change in him, a change in us, because we depend a lot on him. Madhubani also acknowledged the winners. She spoke about the mission and vision of the club, thereby making the guests who had come aware of what this club stands for. You welcome both the guests very well. I would also like and to bring to notice the fact that you even introduced our area director, Toastmaster Raj, very well. And he, of course, we have to hand over the virtual stage to him when the meeting comes to an end. Let me come down to our dear TMOD, Sachin. I think you really took away, you really took this meeting to the height of an observant meeting. Observance meeting. You know, it was shining, it was dazzling. I'm not able to pronounce it, I'm too tired for it. But yes, you actually took away all our fatigue today, you know, and you brought on the spark that was much needed. Thank you for those wonderful laughs, and thank you for making this particular meeting so very humorous. Also, let me now come down to the speakers, Aarti. I would suggest, Aarti, that while you were speaking, certain pauses were required because your transitions, when you're transiting from one part of your speech to another part, is quite unclear. So perhaps, you know, your transitions can be smooth or be easily flowing. That will give you your speech a lot more body and a lot more willingness to listen, make it more interesting. Also, I enjoyed the fact that you really included almost everyone, whoever has even touched your life remotely at Toastmasters. And I was quite surprised when almost everybody who we joined as in January cropped up in your speech. Keep it up, Toastmaster Aarti. We'll do love to have you here with us. But there's one thing I would like to bring to your notice and to notice of everyone. There was a technical glitch. As soon as we meet before 4 o'clock, every role player should be briefed, or every speaker should be briefed, that if there is a glitch, that every speaker has to begin from the point that they have left off at. We can make this as a rule so that we do not, you know, waste time, which is a very, which is a prime important, primary import, prime importance to Toastmasters. We really are time management people. Numerical magical number 7 has stayed with me today, because Sai Kumar also brought or took us all back to how our club started, how we have all become like passengers in one particular train compartment, supporting and holding each other. I liked the achievements that he had listed. I liked his smallest compliments to everyone. And it really made me relook at my club with new eyes. Hip, hip, hooray to that, Sai. Toastmaster Sai. Table topic master, Aarti. Again, a little bit of fluency, a little bit of diction would really help you take you great levels, because some of the topics were really, really left you thinking, you know, at table topics. Sometimes you can even shorten up a table topic, you know, title, so that it becomes easier for the participants to understand what is it that they have to speak about or speak on. All the table topic participants, Pranjali, I like the way you really nosedive into things or at table topics, and you really come up with some good ideas. Keep it on. Ankit, thank you so much, you know. Unfortunately, I missed out on Manas because I got dropped out. But Ankit, thank you for the message. And I will also keep that message in mind. Sometimes magic is created. Sometimes we need to create magic. Very well said, Ankit. I would say, Sagarika, you really spoke well. I am quite taken aback that to hear you say that you really find it difficult to speak. Please join us, and it would be great for us to have you as a part of our club. Let me now again come down to Sachin. Sachin, absolutely wonderful. I liked the way you have brought on a smile on everybody's faces. And the time management, where we faced a problem, I think somewhere or the other, Sachin managed it by the time we came to an end of it. Because as I started marking the timing, which time which we were behind by at least 4 minutes, was caught up as soon as table topic round was complete. And when as soon as it was handed over to Sachin, you know, where he continues his role, he gave all of us a chance, but he ensured that we stayed within that time. There is one error I made, and as a general evaluator, I would like to point out my error. While I opened the segment, I was supposed to introduce both the evaluators when I explained my role. I overlooked introducing Ankit as evaluator 1 and Madhuvani as evaluator 2. So I will also be keeping the error that I have in my mind. All the best to you all always. Looking forward to more meetings. Thank you. Over to you, Toastmaster of the Day.
Thank you so much, General Evaluator Kalpana, for the detailed report you have given from the start to the end. Thank you so much.
Could I just have a minute? I have forgotten to mention my tag team.
Yeah,
I'm so sorry. I would like to say Timer Shirin has really done a wonderful job. Thank you for pointing out that I still needed to take the timer report for both my evaluators. Grammarian Sharia, that was a very detailed report. You had made note of almost all the words, and you also included the errors and why and how they could be rectified. As for my our team member, Anisha, you did a wonderful job. I think you still missed out on quite a few participants. You are supposed to write down R for every participant that is there. No matter who is senior or junior to you in this, everybody qualifies for any errors which needs to be told to them so that they can be a better speaker and a better performer. Thank you so much, Shreya. I'm Anisha. Thank you. Over to you, Sachin. Thank you for the time.
Thanks, Kalpana. Thank you so much. Zoom Master, are we ready for the poll for the best role player? Thank you so much. Everyone, please vote. Next is the poll for best auxiliary role player. Once it is done, I request Zoom Master to please launch the best auxiliary role player role. Poll, sorry. Meanwhile, we'll do it. The polls can be launched in between. I'll request Toastmaster Raj to give us an evaluation or the feedback for the whole flow, what we have done in the meeting. I would like Raj to please turn on the camera. Yeah, Raj, the stage is all yours.
Thank you so much, Sachin. Hello, everyone. Good evening once again. This club, when I got chance to work with on 1st July, I was very happy because it was a home club of Champion Division Director Ankit. In the journey of 3 months, I have been associated with this club and I have witnessed a lot of very good things. Starting with the Prince Medley Award winner by the club, by VP membership Sharon. Club got recognized as outstanding Toastmasters for Manas and Sachin for month of July and August subsequently. When I attend this club meeting, I feel that you all are so creative, so interesting, so engaging, so passionate that it really get me feel that I am not attending virtual meeting, I am attending in-person meeting, because it gives me so connect with everyone of you. All of you are so participative, so passionate, so active in this meeting. A club strength is meeting quality, members' participation, how engaging, how active members are in the club. And you all are very, very, very active in a meeting. It gives that meeting is having a good quality meeting every time. I feel very happy to be with that. I also would like to acknowledge for this club, XCOM, who did a very great job and for winning Power of XCOM Award, which got announced few weeks back for this club. Congratulations to all the XCOM members who did a great job for making sure that you meet all the criteria for Power of XCOM Award. And congratulations to every members who are supporting this club XCOM and excelling. Also, I would like to congratulate today's area contest first runner-up, Ankit Das Gupta and Kalpana, for their film. Some of you will remember, if you have listened, I loved a lot of speeches today where about mentoring was one of the speech. I recollected that thought when I was attending a speech by Aditi Maheswaran. Probably you all must have listened about Aditi Maheswaran. She was speaking once with their Mahij mentor and was saying, I have been in Toastmasters for 5-6 years now. What's more for me? His mentor had responded to him that Toastmaster is like an ocean. What you want to take, it's unlimited. Unlimited benefits, unlimited excellence you can achieve using Toastmasters platform. And you all know where is Aditi Maheswaran right now. She has been a world champion for public speaking first time. So Toastmaster is a great platform where you empower yourself to be a better in-person, to be a better self-growth, to be a better individual. And do not do only for yourself. You inspire people who are in touch with you, who get encouraged that this person, Sachin, or anyone who are in Toastmasters are help in cross improve so much. I do want to be part of Toastmasters. So keep excelling, keep spreading the words of Toastmasters. Keep sharing your achievements, your improvements, how this platform helped you to be better in person. It's not only about speaking and leadership. It's multi-skills platform. You can use this platform to enhance many skills, whether BPPR, whether creative writing, creative thinking, presenting, any number of things you can find it out. This club has been done very good so far under leadership of President Madhubani. Club has so many passionate members with experienced members, and club is doing very good. With my best wishes to everyone and my great blessings to all, to every members of the club, we will connect again in the future meeting with you all. And with this, I'm passing control back to Toastmaster of the day, Sachin.
Thank you so much, Area Director Toastmaster Raj. Thank you so much for the kind words for our club. Manas, can we launch the poll for best auxiliary role player?
Ankit, can you help me? Actually, I am unable to. Actually, it is there.
Okay.
But it is something.
You can continue. I'll check it out. Sachin, you can continue. I'll have to log in from another device. You check it out.
Okay. There is also third poll which we have to create right there.
Can I create another poll?
Yeah, Manish, you can do that quickly. By the time we can hand it over to the presiding officer.
Yeah. So, yes. Okay. So, I'll hand over the stage to the presiding officer, Madhuvani, to take us ahead. Over to you, Toastmaster and presiding officer, Madhuvani.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Sachin. After those inspirational words from our area director, Raj, I have got very less to say. But even before I could go to the end of the meeting, I want to know the feedback or what are the feelings of our other guest whom we have missed to speak, guest Simpson. If he can unmute and say something, what he has felt about the meeting, what are his, what is his takeaway or what is that he has understood from the Toastmaster meeting. Simpson, can you please unmute and say a few words? Simpson, can you hear me? Is he able to unmute or? Okay, I think he's having some problem in unmuting. We'll hear from you later. So as the meeting has come to an end, let us now take a picture of ourselves by the time Manas is ready with the polls, or if he is ready, let us vote for the best auxiliary role player. Manas, are we ready? Or can we click the picture first? If you all can click your, yeah.
Please switch on your cameras and let us pose for the picture, Toastmasters. All of you. Yeah. Please smile. Let us click the photograph.
Sachin, can you help with clicking?
Yeah, Sachin, please. Thank you. Thank you, Toastmaster Sachin. Okay. So is Simpson ready to speak something? Or you can share your experience?
Yeah, sorry. That.
Okay. The poll is ready, so we can all vote for the best auxiliary role player. We are done. Are we done, Manas?
Yes, done.
Okay. So Toastmasters and guests, I can see the results displayed. Now we have the award ceremony and then we will end this meeting. So before that, can we have the best table topic speaker? It was a great meeting, and even our area director Raj was observing us and he gave a good feedback. So also some learnings which we'll have, we will of course implement in our forthcoming meetings. So thank you so much for those observations.
Yeah, can you go for certificates?
Yes, we'll go for certificates. Winners are ready, so you can just display. Yes, it is Toastmaster Ankit for best table topic speaker. Congratulations, DTM Ankit. So we will be spotlighting you and click. This will be the second certificate of today. So he's happy. Let's all clap for DTM Ankit. Have we clicked the picture, Sachin?
Yeah, I got
it. Okay. So now, yes, so this is the best role player, auxiliary role player for our grammarian Shreya. Congratulations to you, Shreya.
Thank you so much.
Yes, so you can smile for the picture. We will not know that you are not well if you smile. Yeah. So we are clicking. Done. Thank you. So who is next? Who is next? Best role player, That's why it was DTM Sachin. Oh, I didn't know. We didn't celebrate.
Don't put me on rock.
We didn't know this. Yeah. It's okay. It's good. Nice to be called, even though we are not, you know. It's nice.
It means dedicated Toastmaster.
Is it? Dedicated Toastmaster. That is from SCT students. Nice. Why don't we use that? We all love, isn't it? DTM. So, Toastmaster Sachin, congratulations on winning the best role player. So can we click? I think he has to click himself or Manas is doing.
Yeah, I'm doing just Manas. A minute.
Yes.
Yes, done.
Yes. So thank you so much, Toastmasters and guests, for being part of our 32nd meeting of today. It has been very interesting meeting with all pearls of wisdom and all inspirational words, and even the toast to our own club by Toastmaster Sai Kumar, Aarti's wonderful speech and nice table topics. So we come to the end of this meeting. In the end, I would want to say that our next meeting will be on 3rd October. So please help our Toastmaster to fill up the roles enthusiastically. Please participate. And then we again thank our area director, and any inputs, all are welcome after the meeting, networking session. So I would end this meeting number 32nd of Speakers Community Toastmasters Club. So thank you so much. See you until the next meeting.